I believe way before Ramadan start, we should always check our intention, our niyyah. Are we really having this intention in our heart that we will fast the month of Ramadan? Alhamdulillah, salatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala wa ba'd. I believe way before Ramadan start, we should always check our intention, our niyyah. Are we really having this intention in our heart that we will fast the month of Ramadan? I learned this during the pandemic and the time that we all living in these days. We lost loved ones right before Ramadan start last year, or during this year who are not going to be with us in Ramadan, even though they were part of our community, family members. Last year, there is a lot of things we were not able to do, many of us around the world, praying even Jumu'ah, Jama'ah, Taraweeh, some were fast, couldn't fast because they were sick. Things change very quickly. But those who had the intention prior to Ramadan to pray in the masjid, to fast the month of Ramadan, to do all these good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give it to them. Those who are consistent in this ibadah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them the reward of it, even if they were not able to fulfill it that year. So that's why it is important for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is important for you, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees in your heart that you have the intention from now to fast Ramadan. Not only to fast Ramadan, to perfect your fasting in the month of Ramadan. Because the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, some people fast and the only thing they gain out of their fast is being thirsty and hungry. Why? Because they do not fulfill the obligations, they do not abstain from the haram during fasting or during this month. So one of the things that we should prepare ourselves with it for Ramadan is now to have the intention in our heart that we will fast Ramadan and we will fast it in the best way, the way the Prophet ﷺ fasted, the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to fast. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees that intention in your heart, Allah says, إِن يَعْلَمِ اللَّهُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ خَيْرًا يُؤْتِكُمْ خَيْرًا مِمَّا أُخِذَ مِنْكُمْ. If Allah sees goodness in your heart, He will give you better than what has been taken from you. In another word, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala look at your heart and see goodness in it, Allah will give you a goodness. Allah will give you goodness. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah doesn't look at your bodies or image or faces or how you look like. Allah will look at your heart and at your deeds. إِنَّمَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ قُلُوبِكُمْ وَأَعْمَالِكُمْ. يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that in the day of judgment, in the day when there will not benefit anyone, wealth or children, but only who comes to Allah with a sound heart, with a sound heart. العلماء رحمهم الله said what sound heart means. الضحاك said in regard to sound heart, he said it's referring to a sincere heart, a heart that filled with sincerity and the intention to do good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran, وَمَنْ يَخْرُجْ مِنْ بَيْتِهِ مُهَاجِرًا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ ثُمَّ يُدْرِكْهُ الْمَوْتُ فَقَدْ وَقَعَ أَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Those who leave their homes and die while immigrating to Allah and His Messenger, their reward has already been secured with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even though they have not reached their destination yet. Who knows who among us will die before Ramadan, days or hours before the month of Ramadan. But we have the intention now that secure inshallah our ajr for this month. Who knows who will be healthy enough to fast, healthy enough to pray, be able to attend the Jumu'ah and the Jama'ah. But if they have the intention for that right now, I'll get the reward for it even if I ended up praying at my home. When you have this intention right now, you benefit two things. Number one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you, aid you, bless you, open doors for you, guide you. Because Allah, if He sees good in you, He will give you good. He will give you access to goodness. Number two, this good intention and this determination right now will help you during the month of Ramadan to review yourself. So you will say, you know what, I have not fulfilled what I intend to do. You know, I'm not doing what I promised to do. Allah, give me the opportunity to live and to enjoy Ramadan and to be able to come to Masjid, but I'm not doing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what I promised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I will do during the month of Ramadan. So that intention from now have a great benefit for you. Make sure you have the intention from now, for example, to finish the Quran. I will make Khatm al-Quran. I will make it twice this year. I have the intention to pray Taraweeh fully from the beginning to the end. I'm not going to come late and I'm not going to leave early. I have the intention to increase my sadaqah. I have the intention to increase my attendance in the masjid, if it is possible. I have the intention to be reconnected with my family. You know what? I'll reach out to my brothers and sisters, to my parents, to my children, to my uncles and aunts who have not talked to them for a while. I'll make sure in this Ramadan, I will come closer to my family. I'll have a better relationship with my children, better relationship with my parents. In this Ramadan, I'll make sure that I please my father and my mother during the month. I'll put a smile on their face every day. I'll make sure that to pray for them more, to give sadaqah on their behalf more, and so on. Have the intention that, you know what, this Ramadan, I'm not gonna, you know, reduce the ajr of Ramadan because of the sins that I do. You know, and all these things that people get distracted, and not only distract them from Ramadan and not take time away from them to do good deeds, but also it add bad deeds into their records in many times because seeing or listening to things which is not allowed. During this Ramadan, I'm not going to miss the sunnah of Fajr and Dhuhr, Maghrib and Isha. Ibn al-Mubarak rahimahullah said, رُبَّ عَمَلٍ كَثِيرٌ تُصَغِيرُهُ النِّيَّةِ. Sometimes a small deed, but the intention behind it will make it so big, will make it so great, grandiose. It is because of that intention. Because when you do something, you intend to do it to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Make sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees from you today the intention to do good during this month of goodness. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.